You know, Brother Hoover, that is in prison today, you have him out there in Florence, Colorado. I read his life. He once was in criminal enterprise. But GD, he changed it to mean growth and development. And when Larry Hoover changed the aim of the so-called gangster disciples to growth and development and began to guide them into absolutely good things, you arrested him in prison and gave him 4 or 5 life sentences. Why did you do that? You were afraid, because Larry Hoover had the ability to organize young black men in particular. Jeff Fort, Malik Kaba, is in prison. You don't ever intend to let him out. But he's in prison because he could organize young black men. Well, next week's broadcast, we intend to talk about the political prisoners, not only the masses of black people, but black and Native Americans who have been languishing in prison, not because they are criminals, but because the government of the United States fears their ability to organize young people. Geronimo Jijaga, Geronimo Pratt, a decorated Vietnam veteran, a member of the Black Panther Party. But when he came out of the service, you know you trumped up a charge against him, put him in prison for 27 years of his life simply because he was a military strategist and genius, and you feared that he would organize black men into a military brigade, platoon, regiment to fight for our liberation. Is it wrong when people are oppressed that they should unite and organize for their liberation? This is the evil of the government of the United States of America. But getting back to Pharaoh, he said, "Come on, conspiracy. Let us deal wisely with them, lest they multiply and it come to pass that when there falleth out any war, they join also unto our enemies and fight against us. So get them up out of the land." And what was the plan? He said, "When ye do the office of a midwife to the Hebrew women, and see them upon the stools, if it be a son, then ye shall kill him. But if it be a daughter, then she shall live." You organized, deputized, and supervised the killing of young black men. And you're still on that same program today.